electrical circuit. In every electrical circuit, there is an energy supplier, energy receiver, and the connecting wires. These electrical circuits are simple electrical circuits, complex electrical circuits. What is the simple electrical circuit? Let us consider this is the simple electrical circuit. This is EMF of the cell. This is the resistor. The cell which provides the energy, R is the resistor which can receive the energy. It is ready to give and it is ready to take. Then through the connecting wires, the cell will supply the energy, resistor will take the energy. Only one energy supplier, only one energy utilizer, then it is called simple electrical circuit. Only one cell is there, one resistor is there, and the connecting wires are there. Therefore, this is called simple electrical circuit. Then battery drives the current I through the resistor. In this electrical circuit, what is the potential difference between these two points? What is the potential difference between these two points? What is the current in the circuit? What is the effective resistance of the circuit? Now we are taking simple electrical circuit. Only one cell is there, only one resistor is there, and the connecting wires are there. Cell supplies the energy, resistor receives the energy. Cell supplies the energy, resistor can absorb the energy. Then cell drives the current through the resistance. Here in this electrical circuit, between any two points, what is the potential difference? What is the total current in the electrical circuit? What is the resistance of the electrical circuit? To calculate this one, Ohm's law is suitable. Ohm's law is suitable. That means what? By using the Ohm's law, we can calculate the potential difference between any two points. We can calculate the current in the circuit. We can calculate the effective resistance of the circuit. This can be done by using the Ohm's law. Suppose there is another type of circuit. This is called one circuit. Here there is a resistance. Here there is a resistance. Here there is a cell, and let us consider. Here EMF E1, EMF E2, EMF E3, resistor R1, resistor R2. Such a circuit is called complex electrical circuit. In the complex electrical circuit, what is the potential difference between these two points? What is the current in the circuit? What is the effective resistance? Suppose let us consider this is a point A, this is the point B. Through this resistor R1, across the points AB, what is the potential difference? Through the resistance R1, what is the current? And what is the effective resistance of the circuit? How to calculate? That calculation cannot be done by the Ohm's law. Here in this case, there are two types of electrical circuits: simple electrical circuits and complex electrical circuit. Only one cell, only one resistor, then it is called simple electrical circuit. Two or more cells are available, two or more resistors are available, then it is called complex electrical circuit. In a simple electrical circuit, To calculate the electrical parameters, we are using the Ohm's law. But in the complex electrical circuits, between any two points, how to calculate the potential difference? How to calculate the current in any branch of the circuit? What is the effective resistance of the circuit? That cannot be calculated by using the Ohm's law. Therefore, in the complex electrical circuits, to calculate the potential difference, to calculate the current, to calculate the resistance, we are using Kirchhoff laws. Here we are going to introduce what to say Kirchhoff laws. Kirchhoff laws. By using the Kirchhoff laws, in a complex electrical circuit, we can calculate the potential difference, we can calculate the resistance, effective resistance, we can calculate the total current in the circuit. Now, here Kirchhoff laws are two. Right, first one, Kirchhoff current law. Kirchhoff's current law. Second one, Kirchhoff voltage law. Kirchhoff laws are two, Kirchhoff current law and Kirchhoff voltage law. Kirchhoff's first law, Kirchhoff current law, is also known as Kirchhoff current law. Kirchhoff voltage law is also known as second law. Therefore, here Kirchhoff first law. Here this one, Kirchhoff second law. Now we shall discuss about the Kirchhoff first law, that is known as Kirchhoff current law. In a simplified form, Kirchhoff current law. In a simplified form, Kirchhoff's voltage law. Kirchhoff current law, Kirchhoff voltage law. Now, what is the Kirchhoff current law? This is the Kirchhoff current law. While going to discuss about the Kirchhoff current law, what is the junction? What is the junction? The point where the currents are going to meet. The point where the currents are going to divide is called junction, electrical junction. The point where the currents are going to divide, the points where the currents are going to meet is called junction. Let us consider this is a resistor. There is another resistor. There is another resistor. Now there is another resistor. These resistors, what to say, R1, R2, right, R3 and R4. From the point A, let us consider there is a current. As the current is traveling through the resistance, here there is another point that is called B. At the point B, the incoming current I is going to divide, that is I1 and I2 and I3. Here I current at the point B is going to divide as I1, I2, I3. Therefore, this point is called junction.